It's a good formation. We've got Shane Harrison and Funky, Volker Funken is his name, and Mark Torreson and Jethro Nelson. And you've already seen Jethro Nelson today.
He was flying the, he took off in one of the Harvards, and he was also flying the Jet Provost.
Quite a talented pilot. He's a Tornado pilot from the RAF and now works for Air Affairs down at Nowra.
So your skill base then is very, very high. How many of these Lears are you operating down there?
The company has 13 Lears now. It's been quite a rapid increase from just a couple a few years ago. And it's to service the jet aviation support contract for the Department of Defence.
Of course, the company is wholly Australian owned and headquarters down there at the Albatross Technology Park.
Absolutely, Australian owned and operated, and it's growing quickly and very excited to be involved.
And it's great that it is wholly Australian owned too. I really find that fantastic, particularly for what you do. Such a wide range of work.
Yeah, it's quite exciting. A lot of work with the Air Force, and a little bit of a break in the formation. One goes up, one goes down. Yes, the job they do for the RFS is quite critical, and it gives very exact mapping for the RFS headquarters to direct their assets.
Now, the company also provides a lot of common services support for the Commonwealth, and aviation life support, non-destructive testing, logistical support. There's not very much that you guys don't do. You manufacture, design and manufacture the pilot.
That's easy. You've got a very good target ground and a very good gun.
They are tested to destruction, and the gun wing, of course, they're very accurate. This is actually Mark Torreson and Jethro going past with their gear down. Show you the birdie shot. And that means we're expecting Shane Harrison and Funky to come in over our heads very shortly.
And I think we can see them just slightly out to the east.
Here it comes, everybody look behind you towards the moon, and you'll see Shane Harrison coming in for his fast points.
Because some of the other things that you guys do are the Naval Aviation System Program Office, you provide development of installations with designs for equipment for RAM aircraft, for different equipment that they want to put in there.
The engineering and design skills of the company are quite amazing. It's very well, 1984, just about the time the fixed wing fleet airline was paying off, Air Affairs stepped in and took on much of the load and does it very efficiently and to an extent better than us old baby types to do.
You definitely do not get to see the Learjet service when they don't think we're still in their shanties.
Yeah, most people think of Learjets as executive carrying VIPs, and it's a very different mission that we perform with them.
And this design is actually a development of one of their previous aircraft, the Stearman Cloudster. It became the primary trainer of choice for both the US Army Air Corps
of Lucas. Like the famous movie about the Glenn Miller band and his story. It's a concept, it's an idea, it's very much Hollywood, but it's still quite a fun movie to watch, just it's not exactly the truth.
Well, I was actually fortunate enough to meet one of their ace pilots out at the gathering of Mustangs and Legends at Kissimmee in Florida, and it was gentlemen. Very, very quiet, and he and I were out there at 6 o'clock in the morning looking at the Mustangs, and we sat down under the wing and talked for a couple of hours about it until his daughter came to find him wondering where he was.
Off on the way, you just get talk and lose time, but as you can see above us, Chris Clark putting the Stearman through its paces and showing us about energy management. He's starting high and will convert the energy of height into the energy required to do his display, and he'll slowly lose altitude until he's down lower at the end.
The aircraft type was actually born in the US Navy in 1934 as the NS-1, and it was also produced for the US Army Air Corps as the PT-17, the PT-18 and the PT-27. PT-27 being the land release version, 300 of which went off to Canada, and they were fitted, most of them, with canopies for the very harsh Canadian winter. The NS1, known to the US Navy as the Yellow Peril. They're all painted yellow as training aircraft. Generally had a 220 horsepower radial engine, an R670, but a lot of damage. He is integral to the operations of the Australian Defence Force overseas, and particularly in disaster relief, where Australia has provided such relief to things like the Christchurch New Zealand earthquake, to Japan earthquakes, and humanitarian missions throughout Southeast Asia and Papua New Guinea. Ha ha ha.